Should we do it again? Alright. Do it again. It's no problem. North. Russia. Still can't see it. And that's not gonna change. The whole flight. Now, three volcanoes made this island. The biggest one's at this end, the smaller one's at the other end. The smallest is that peninsula right out there called Kaulapapa, which is where the leprosy colony was located, you may have heard of. It was begun out there in the 1860s. No cure, contagious, quarantine, kind of made sense. The issue, of course, became the treatment. People just sort of thrown out there and left, in some cases in barrels. It was very nice. Eventually, a Catholic priest moved down there. His name was Father Damien. He was from Belgium. His efforts would, of course, greatly improve their quality of living and led to representation in Hawaii's government team. Still there, about 100 people live down there, only 12 remaining that were placed out there as lepers years ago, well into their 90s. It is a national park, and you can get out there on a donkey. Haven't done that yet. This Wailau Valley here. Now typically Hawaiian volcanoes are called shield volcano, which means when you look at them from above they're kind of oval in shape and the profile tends to be a dome. Now with that in mind, if you look at Molokai's eastern side here on a map, you'll see that it looks like one third to one half of that oval is gone. And that is indeed the case. The experts say that a tsunami wave did it. It was moving along at 500 knots and was 2,000 feet high when it hit. See, it drug 600 cubic miles of material away, deposited in the ocean there to the left, towards Russia. Sorry, last time I promised. Now, of course, Molokai has been eroding away ever since, and it will do so until there's nothing. Like every Hawaiian island. We'll be right back. always suspected a helicopter could do that. Now we know. There's Maui over there on the right. We're going to cut back across Pailolo to the west side of West Maui, Kanapali and Lahaina. Now working our way back across towards, like I said, Kanapali, straight ahead there on the west side of West Maui. Over there on the right, of course, is the island of Lanai'i. It's privately owned. It was purchased in 1922 by the Dole family for $1 million. Oh, well, 98% of it. Well, it's covered in pineapple for many years as a result of that, but they don't grow pineapple there anymore at all. A couple of big resort hotels over there now, the Lodge at Ko'ele and Manele Bay, which are nice, I hear. And they supposedly have golf courses that are nice too. There's an airport over there, a power plant, 2,500 people, and an estimated 3,500 deer. Hunting tours make money over there if you were interested. Go over there and do that. Yeah, they'll freeze it and mail it home to you. It's true. Recently though, the night it was purchased for somewhere around $700 million is the rumored sale price. To a guy called Larry. They say that Larry wants to cover it with windmills and organic farms and a desalination project to turn salt water to fresh water for the organic farms, which should be powered by the windmills. Alright. Fair enough. $700 million though. I was like, alright. Then I was like, well, wait. Somebody paid $2 billion for the Los Angeles Dodgers. That's a baseball team. I like baseball, but $2 billion for like 30 guys in varying degrees of shape, half of whom are probably cheating. Small piece of real estate, polluted city, old stadium. Or, for one third of the price, you can get yourself a nice clean air Hawaiian island and your little chunk of refuge from the apocalypse. Ellison. Larry Ellison. That's the guy. Oracle software. He He's heading through a heck of a New Year's party, both years. Oh,